I was recently rewatching this video that I made last year about AI, and I was thinking if I made this today, I would have been way harsher on AI in Midjourney than I was. I made it right at the start of the whole trend, and it's more or less just my base initial reaction to the thing's capabilities, which amounts to, it's kind of crazy and impressive what this thing can do, but it's also sort of off-putting. My position now is that it's not impressive at all, and it's embarrassing that we were ever suckered in by the basic sleight of hand trick that the tech is playing. It's not off-putting in any sort of artistic way, only in a sense that it sucks and it should die. When I show the AI images with the voiceover underneath it saying unbridled imagination, it's giving AI way too much credit. I think what I'm trying to say there is still true. We can imagine things in our head, but what God has already materialized in the real world is always more beautiful, and that we tend to give more credit to our own imagination than we do to God's. And yet, God has still given us this imagination, so the idea is that there needs to be a synthesis between those two things, and that's really where real art lies. The Chesterton quote at the end also reveals something true about AI, and it's that AI is the perfect example of scientific fatalism. It literally can only depict things as they have always been. AI can only take in what already exists there. It can't predict a new change in anything. It can't understand why it's so striking that a rose should be red. It can only make a rose red because it always has been red. So many things are just grotesque copies of the real thing, and AI art is just one more example of this that we have to fight against.
Thank you. In so many ways, it's a lament, because it feels like the neighborhood is dying. Because the more separated you get from what it used to be, the less it is the neighborhood anymore. So when you add like if you look behind here and there's houses and storage units back there instead of trees and then a field and then trees behind it, it changes the entire character of what this place is. It's not this place anymore, it's something different. Like the amount of times that I've walked past this retention pond here, just walking past and observing it, or not observing it, even. It's just different now. Like, you look back at what the footage even used to look like. Way different from this. In the sense that, like, none of these houses were even there. It just develops. You're fine. It's just sad. Like, and even knowing that you're not gonna live here forever. It's just, you get not even attached to a place. Like, you're attached to it, but you're attached to it for a reason. Like, it's not arbitrary that you grow fond of something. Like, there's qualities inherent in that place that you come to know and, like, in a sense become a real part of you that's hard to let go. This is the sign. That says they're working on changing this land into something else. It's just the aging of the world. That's what it is. But it's also, it's just the idea of progress and things moving on past what they used to be into the new horizons without thinking about what those new horizons should be. But, like, I don't know, when it's personal to you, it just feels, I don't know if it feels like it hurts more, if it actually is worse. I made one of these last year, I don't even know if I'll make this into anything, but I made something where it's like, it's just seeing stuff around the neighborhood, and I don't get sick of it. Like, it's like meditating, really. Like, the fact that there's these things to meditate on in the neighborhood, like, that the neighborhood has that character where there's things I can look at alone, says something about the quality that this place has. And, you know, you're sure there's other places like it, but it's not my place.
Never gonna see it again. Probably. Never know. The strength of the absurd. You never know.